crude is bouncing back. It's higher on the day. I'm taking a look now. It's about 1% for WTI. Still in bear market territory, though. Scott Nations and Bill Baruch breaking down what's behind that move. Scott, let's begin with you. What's your take on crude now?
Nice rally from the bottom, about a dollar and a half. Unfortunately, it came on the news of explosions in Beirut, so we're worried about geopolitical turmoil. And that's part of the supply problem. Also on the supply problem, you know, last week we saw a 10.6 million barrel draw from supply, and now we're starting to wonder if we're going to see another incident tomorrow when we get supply data again. Add the fact that domestic production is extremely weak, and that last week we saw the lowest level of crude oil inputs going back to the early 1990s. And so as far as the bulls are concerned, supply is where it's at.
Yeah. Bill, where's the catalyst to break it out?
That's the thing. We really don't have a catalyst right now. I see the path of least resistance higher. That's undoubted. But I don't really want to be a buyer until we see lower prices. $34.5, $35 is where I see value. And here's why. If you look at the chart, where crude oil fell down March 6th, there's a big, big gap up there on the September contract, $42.5. That's overhead resistance. On the front month contract, about $41.5. That's keeping rallies in check. The other part of it is the trade is becoming overcrowded. If you look at historically, you have about 400,000 contracts long right now and about 350,000 contracts net long right now, which is about 75-80% against historic full capacity of what we've seen position-wise. So if this market were to start moving lower at all, you start to see some liquidation. But also, if everybody's already bought, who is left to buy? So I need to see this market lower to find value or really break out above 42.5.
All right. Appreciate it.